Hello everybody and welcome to the slightly somber but celebratory fireside chat that we're having, not at the fireside but at the tent side. That has happened for various reasons, but we quite like the tent side here. And today we are going to pay tribute to the great Queen of Djuma, Karula. And we don't know what has happened to her. I'm not sure how many of you have watched one of these before or how long all of you have been watching for. But to give you a brief background, Karula, a 13-year-old leopardess and mother to now 10 independent cubs, has disappeared. She's now been missing for about, I think it probably must be 10 weeks now. And the assumption, of course, is that she is not coming back. One hesitates to use the term dead because we have not found a carcass. It's possible, maybe, that she is off raising another litter somewhere else. It's highly, highly unlikely, however, and it is much more likely that a fate has befallen her, as it always does out here, or often does, perhaps a male lion, perhaps a male leopard. Anyway, many of you, some of you for up to 9 years, have spent time with her. I've been around her for about 2 years, and she certainly captured my heart. And tonight we're going to pay tribute to her. And you can send through a few questions or send through some comments if you'd like to on the hashtag SafariLIVE, and we'll do our best to address those during the course of the show. I don't think we'll get to them all, but we'll certainly do our best. I will be jamed shortly by Join and also by Tristan, hopefully, with any luck. And we are going to share our memories of Karula with you. And then we will show you a little tribute video at the end of what's happening here afterwards. We're going to go straight to my highlight clip now, and it was, of course, just after the birth of the new royal pair.
Oh, wow. This is too special for words. I can't believe this. Good afternoon, Your Majesty. Those cubs are now only 10 feet from us. They're looking at the vehicles. They've stopped at the vehicle. They're taking the cue. Yeah, she's chuffing. She's telling them to come with her.
This is unbelievable.
Oh my goodness.
Okay, now.
Right, there you are, everybody. So that has been the astounding experience that we've had with Karula. Now, many of you have had that a few times, and that was my favorite incident. I mean, there were so many, and when they came to me and said, which one would you choose, I didn't really know. But that one, with those tiny little cubs that are now so much bigger, Shongile and Hosana, was a very special one for me. And, of course, we like to think of these leopards perhaps as wanting to share their youngsters with us.
We
have that feeling that they are giving us some kind of honour by bringing their youngsters. Now, whether they do that consciously or not, I don't know, but it certainly felt like a great honour. Welcome, Tristan.
Thank you very much, James. Sorry, I'm a bit late.
That's all right.
A bit tardy. Mm-hmm. It's okay. We were doing good things out there.
Yes, I'm sure you were.
Yes.
it is, of course, a somber fireside chat today.
Yes, it is. Indeed. Yes. It's not something that is very easy to talk about, I don't think.
No. Now, I'm told that you have met all of her surviving offspring, bar one.
Yes, that's right.
And that one is?
Quarantine, which is becoming a sort of a bogey leopard. Every time I go to Cheetah Plains and the hope that he's going to be around, he unfortunately tends to elude me. But I have been fortunate to have seen all of them, and even the ones that haven't survived. So, well, that we don't know what's happened to them. So much like Karula, Shivinzi was one of the females that also just disappeared at one point. And so we don't know what sort of fate she had and where she went to. But yes, it's been a pretty special thing to have seen every single one of those cubs bar quarantine. And they all have a sort of special place in one's heart and guiding career, that's for sure.
Can you list them all? Do you remember them all?
I do. So it was, well, it was Tandy and Shadow, who was called Tingana, actually, at the time, until Tingana arrived, and then her name was changed to Shadow. Then she had, after that, Induna and Mishu, two boys. Now, both of those ended up pushing into the eastern, well, sorry, western side of Kruger. Mm-hmm. So they're around Hamilton's Hoyahoya, that area. Then she had, after that, Shivinzi and Shivambalana. Mm-hmm. Which Shivinzi, like we say, just disappeared, and Shivambalana, obviously we know he's now also on the eastern side of the reserve. And then after that, she had the one that unfortunately got killed by the hyena, which obviously I didn't meet that, so that was nobody really had much time with that leopard. And then after that, she had Kanuma and Quarantine, which I've seen Kanuma, and not Quarantine, as we've just spoken about, and then after that, Shungile and Hosanna. Good. There we go.
Well, let's have a look at Tristan's highlight of the latest two.
Yes, exciting indeed, Jamie. We came to where you left them last night, and there you can see Karula is standing waiting for us. She was just sitting on the side of the road, and she is calling quite a bit, so I think she's looking for the cubs. There comes little Shungile now, just a bit to your left, Craig. There we go, and we're going to get a meeting of all of them together. Look at that, isn't that amazing? So Mom has obviously been out hunting, and the cubs have now been called. And I wonder if she maybe doesn't have a kill. It'll be interesting to see where she goes now. But look at how they rub up on her just to reaffirm that bond. And typical Hosanna fashion, shoving his bum in his mom's face. That's how he likes to let Mom know that he's happy to see her.
Right, so that was Tristan's highlight. And Tristan, what about that made you choose it?
I think it's a tough one, because when I arrived, I actually didn't get much time with Karula while being at Safari Live. She kind of disappeared within the first month that I was here. So the thing about that sighting was that one was finding her. It was the most random situation. We were literally just driving down the road, and I can't remember who was on camera with me, but they just said leopard, and there she was sitting right next to the road staring at us. And then the whole process of her kind of walking and calling those cubs, and the cubs coming out, and the greeting that was going on. And at that stage, I don't know if you remember, Hosanna was being a particular bully to Karula, and he used to come in and just hit her with his tail and with his backside. And so it was just a sort of, just to watch that affection that was there between her and the cubs was quite a special thing. And like I say, I didn't unfortunately get too much time with her at Safari Live, but it was definitely one of the sort of standout sightings of her with the cubs, for sure. And we got to follow her the whole morning, which was probably the best part. And at one stage, actually later on in that sighting, all three of them ended up in the same tree together. And you know, that sort of visual of coming down the road, and you've got this massive marula tree and these leopards draped from each branch, it was just fantastic. So it was a very special leopard, that's for sure.
When was the first time you saw her? This is Jamie, by the way.
Hi.
Hi.
The first time I ever saw her was in that block north of Gallego. And I was with Andrew, and Brent was with Two Cheetah, and we saw her for 5 minutes, and then she disappeared into that block north of Gallego. And Andrew Francis, who was on camera with me at the time, I'd just started working here, it took him a long time to forgive me for losing that particular leopard, because he filmed her for about 5 seconds and then she vanished. True to form.
Yes. True to form. Yeah. Right, we're going to have a look at Jamie's highlight now. Here you go.
So why is everything running? Here come more. Wild dogs! There's wild dogs in the sighting! Unbelievable! Oh, it's going after the Inyala! Oh, it's a standoff. The Inyala doesn't have any way to go. There they go, they've got it. Oh, poor little thing. You didn't really have a chance, did you? Look, she stole it. She's running off with the kill. You clever girl. This is incredible. Why, yes. Yes, I will have two breakfasts. Thank you.
Nana Bushbuck was saying.
Yes. Inyala and Bushbuck Buffet, says Viam. Unbelievable. You clever, clever girl. These are moments in the bush that you don't often get to see.
So that's Jamie's particular highlight, and why did you choose that one?
I chose that one because it was such an epitome of the opportunist that Karula could be, as all leopards are, but especially when she was looking after her two cubs, and just how proud she looked of herself when she went down after the wild dogs had disappeared and they went off to go and drink at a pan, and she trotted down and she got the kill and she trotted back to the tree, and she just looked, she became very easy to identify with because there was such a look of satisfaction on her face.
She looked almost like a pony in an equestrian.
Yes, she did, that high
situation.
Trot.
In the passage.
Yes, exactly. There was this high trot, and I think Karula was one of those leopards that seemed to have that every time she managed to pull something off that was quite sneaky, that she had this kind of trot off when she when she did those kind of things. So
she looked like she came off best in a deal.
Yes.
Which she had,
which
really.
Exactly, which she, she's exactly what had happened. She was just so, and she knew her cubs were fine. She knew that they'd long ago learned to climb trees when wild dogs are around. It was a lovely surprise.
Mm. Now we've got a comment from Cayenne, I think, or Tyann, with a K, Cayenne. You say you loved Karula very much and you hope your cubbies, her cubbies, will be all right. Well, we all hope that too. And I mean, certainly, well, it was a little bit worrying. We haven't seen the two of them for some time. But Tristan, you reckon their tracks are hurtling about on the Gari main road?
This morning there was tracks for female, male. But it's been difficult because with Tundi and Tumba being around. Those tracks are so similar in size. I mean, Tumba and Hosana both have the similar size feet, and obviously Shongile is slightly smaller than Tundi, but they're all moving around in a similar area at the moment and have been seen together quite a few times. So it's difficult to say, but there's definitely tracks of young male leopards moving about heavily on our southern boundary, and there's been lots of reported sightings of the two of them, and I think they'll be fine. If they've made it this long without Karula, I think it's pretty positive for the future, that's for sure. Well, I would hope so, and I really hope that we do end up seeing a lot more of them in the coming few months.
Yeah.
Arlene, you say you first saw her in 2009. Now, that is some 8 years ago. It must have been very, very special to watch her for that length of time. Now, before we head across to our tribute video, I must just say that every single presenter that's ever worked here, and I'm sure every viewer that's ever seen her, appreciates what Karula's done. And I just want to say, on behalf of Brent and Taylor, especially as the current presenters and all presenters past, I want to pass their tribute on as well. They've loved being with her and they'd love to be here now to pay tribute, but obviously they're in different parts of the world and that's not possible. Thank you everyone for joining us. We're going to hand you over now to a highlights clip of the great Queen of Djuma, and long may she live in our memories. Good morning, Karula. How do you do? Lovely to meet you. Oh, look at that. Hi.
I know many viewers have had the opportunity to follow Karula since she was very young, thanks to Wild Earth. And every sighting of her has been a thrill.
Oh, look, this is too special. She's such a fantastic mother.
My favorite sighting of Karula, which is hard to pick one because there's so many after 9 years, it would have to be the time that she was walking down the road and a dove flew up from the middle of nowhere and she caught it in midair.
Oh! Guys, that was amazing! So I just spotted that last second.
She caught it. She just grabbed a dove here.
I adopted a new baby in April 2008, and when he was 2 days old, I brought him home from the hospital. I named him Koda Karula. This is him back then. And Koda, this is him right now. That's what he looks like every day when we watch SafariLIVE.
And then there was that sighting on SafariLIVE with Brent when Karula and Shadow faced off and Karula grew that huge bubble that just seemed to last forever.
Isn't that incredible? Karula's blown a bubble.
We miss Karula. We hope she's back sometime soon. Right, Koda? Karula?
Yep.
It's okay. I'm not gonna come too close. And hello, you old friend. Isn't she spectacular?
think the most unique thing about Karula is that signature marking across her forehead that spells out the word wow.
So the W is there, and the O and the next W. So there's the wow on Karula.
I've never seen a leopard, and I don't think a leopard will ever have the word wow written in spots across her forehead. I think that describes her perfectly.
It's a definition that sums up Karula, the Queen of Djuma, perfectly.